This is a review video regarding the 12th of September 2020 IELTS exam. Before starting, make sure to like, share and subscribe our channel and follow us on Instagram and Telegram. Links are available into description box. Task 1 was map that was as it same according to our prediction. As a proof, firstly you can check our prediction video. Some people think the government should pay for healthcare and education, but other people claim that it is the individual's responsibility. Discuss both views and give your opinion. There is a debate that has raged on and off among the public for years with no resolution in sight, whether the costs in healthcare and education are the government's duty or citizens' responsibility. In my opinion, these essential services should be funded by the government, not the individual. On the one hand, some people argue that medical and school fees should be borne by individuals for a range of reasons. First, health and study are personal matters as it is of vital importance for each person to maintain a healthy lifestyle and have a well-rounded education. For example, if citizens have to pay for medical and education, they could be more responsible for looking after their health as well as pursuing their study. Second, it might be unfair for the governments to sponsor these services. In fact, governments can spend a large chunk of the national budget on these services, whereas they can use it to improve infrastructure or solve current environmental problems. On the other hand, the idea that governments should bear healthcare and education fees seems to be more plausible. Since many citizens have to pay various kinds of tax and compulsory medical insurance in some countries, they deserve to have a free education and healthcare system. In fact, by exempting people from fees, they would be happier to pay taxes and governments would not worry about tax evasion. In addition, given that tuition and medical care are free of charge, students and workers would focus more on their study and career without worrying about financial burdens. As a result, it would help boost the economy of the country. In conclusion, healthcare and education is a good way to spend government money because it fosters economic growth in a variety of ways.